owner Fry.
Leadership, flesh, and brilliance and excellence.
I shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Light shine bright everywhere we go.
Leadership, impacting society with peace, love, and hope.
Everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people.
Shining the light for America, the James A. Hendricks School of Leadership.
Happy, 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 happy Thursday. Programming note. Tomorrow is Fearless Faith Friday. And we're going to be talking about knowing Jesus. Okay, so that's my interpretation of knowing Jesus. Saturday, special edition, a simulated radio address, parodies of all parodies, Bill Clinton. We'll be doing that on the 12th and 23rd. Okay, today's episode is called Joe Biden's Lost Paradise. Ain't there always trouble in paradise in the Joe Biden White House? Let me tell you something. I'd much rather be in an esoteric hermitage than to have to deal with this rules for thee and rules for me bullcrap. So we're going to take two news stories from Town Hall and analyze them, if you know what I mean. Here's the first one. Biden reaffirms plans to make oil and gas even more expensive. Now, I don't know who wrote this piece. Katie Pavlich. Biden's having a little help from Mr. Zolpec. President Joe Biden has an interview with the Weather Channel where he vows to continue his, you know, making oil and gas less affordable. Start building that hermitage. I'm going to tell you something right now. Start building that hermitage, because I'll tell you something. Biden is so idiotic. Oil and gas is the lifeblood of the economy. And my hope, I mean, okay, we can't impeach him because of how divided the Senate is. Technically, we can't. But to take away oil and gas to make it less affordable, let me tell you something. There's already a revolt against his butt. Okay, Saudi Arabia is already going to raise the price of oil as it is, inflation, and Biden wants to ratchet it up. He is demented. He is crazy and demented. How do you tell me? The craziness that goes on. I mean, I'm not a hermit. I'm a social butterfly. But let me tell you something. They start, these liberals start this. Let's have the esoterics, such as myself and my good friend, Father Michael. Let's have them. Let's get this settled up. Oh, what's new here? The second article. I'm going to definitely analyze it. We're gonna, probably going to put them together. And this is going to be a this is going to be part of a playlist. I was going to have the teachings of my good friend, Father Michael. But in many ways, I know how he would respond to this. I mean, he's been my best friend. I've known him for 14 years. This is written by Julio, Rocio, I think is his name. Oh, look at this. Senator Elizabeth Warren was in no mood to talk about the growing mountain of evidence of President Joe Biden's involvement with his son's shady foreign business dealings. Choosing to change the subject to the Supreme Court. Uh-huh. I'm a social butterfly. But if they're gonna build a communist nation, like these Democrats are trying to do, put me in that Hermitage. Put me in that Hermitage, because I'll tell you something. It's my hope that the American people are getting tired of it. 2024, they won't stand for it. The people will start setting up a citizenry that enforces voters' integrity. That's what we should do, instead of just leaving it to the powers that be. And while we're at it, what about a citizen legislature? We're trying to stop another steal. Okay? And if what my hopes are true, which I hope they are, here comes the big 2024 red pill. And I hope Americans are ready to take it, because Joe Biden is wrecking this country into the ground. And Elizabeth Warren? I don't know. These two. Well said of Trump, of Elizabeth Warren, when he called her Pocahontas. Seriously, do we need these people in power? How long are they going to cover it up? Oh, she's not as old as I thought. She's about a year older than the man who raised me, my daddy. So, she was born in Oklahoma City. How did somebody make it all the way from Oklahoma City to be the center of Massachusetts with such twisted values? I tell you what, bad Hermitage is coming. Bad Hermitage is coming, okay? Because I tell you, unless we American people this year and next year start rising up and saying, hey, enough's enough. Now, I hope you enjoy listening to the James A. Hendrick School Leadership. If you like what you hear, please subscribe, become a part of the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership. This is Jimi Hendrix, and until next time, keep up the hope. Keep up the faith. Put this down in your soul, please. Put it in your soul so you can understand. I need you to understand what I'm about to say now. Jesus saves, and we're all going to be okay. Take care and be proactively informed. God bless you guys. Remember, from the bottom of my heart, Jimmy loves you. I really love you.